what to do if you want an OLED TV but live in a high humidity environment. Humidity can be a real problem, not just for people, but for all organic things, and that includes organic light emitting diodes, which is exactly what OLED TVs use to make a picture. Now, humidity is not great for electronics in general, so already we're starting at a disadvantage, but OLED compounds are organic and they degrade faster in high humidity environments, not just because of the moisture, but because of the accelerated oxidation and therefore degradation that takes place in those environments. Look, an OLED TV is not gonna die right away. You won't notice a problem within a year. I don't think you'd probably see a problem within 2 years. But after that, no guarantees, because even though you may not see the issues right away, the chemical breakdown is happening at a faster level than it would in a lower humidity environment. Now, I'm not just making this up. I may not be a scientist myself, but there are scientific papers published on this. Three Indian scientists published an extensive report about the effect of high humidity on OLED displays in the Journal of Electronics and Communication Engineering. So yes, if you live in a high humidity environment and don't have climate control that regulates the humidity for the area in which the OLED TV is to be placed, then you should probably get a dehumidifier. Now, it is also true that high heat can negatively impact OLED displays, but we're talking about long-term exposure to high direct heat. That's one of the many reasons that putting an OLED outdoors is generally a bad idea. Direct sunlight, even on a mild day outdoors, can damage an OLED panel. Don't worry about the heat in your home being a problem so much. The OLED's not gonna hurt unless you're hurting yourself